Let us talk about significance of surface tension. To understand the significance of surface tension, let's consider a container in which, say, a liquid is filled. Say, this is a container in which a liquid is filled up to the top. And in this situation, we have already discussed that every point on the surface of liquid will behave as if it is under tension. Or every point will be experiencing an outward force of attraction by its neighboring particles. Now, in this situation, if I consider a hypothetical line, say this line AB on the liquid surface, then every particle on this line will be experiencing the force on left and right side of this line. So, we can say the resulting effect of all these forces will be acting in a direction normal to the line. So, we can say in this situation, the total force due to surface tension acting on the line will be zero as it is being pulled by equal forces in opposite direction. But if I talk about a line which is there on the edge of the container and only on one side of this container, only on one side of the edge as liquid is present and on the other side there is no liquid. This line will be experiencing the force in the direction only along the surface of liquid. So, we can say net force due to surface tension on this line, say this line is xy, it will be non-zero. So, using surface tension, we can find out the total force. For this purpose, we need to give a mathematical significance or analytical significance for surface tension. And its numerical definition I'll write. So, very carefully you just note it down. Here numerically we can say surface tension is numerically defined as the force acting per unit length of a hypothetical line drawn on a liquid surface normal to it in either direction. Here we can say if a hypothetical line is drawn and it experiences a force, net force F and F on the two sides and say if its length is L. So, here we can say the surface tension of liquid can be given as T. T is the symbol we use to denote a surface tension for the liquid. It can be given as F upon L. And its unit we can write as Newton per meter obviously. And using this relation, if we wish to find out the force acting on a line in one direction, then we can say if this line is of length L1, we can say the total force F1 acting on it will be TL1. If T is the surface tension of the liquid, as force in either direction can be given as the product of surface tension and the length of the line on which it is acting. Similar analysis we can understand here with the help of the situation. Here you can see if there is a wire frame on which there is a soap film. If we place a loop of a thread on the soap film, it will be arbitrary in shape. And say, if we just pick the soap film between the loop by a needle, as you can see here, the force of surface tension will start acting on the loop segments in outward direction where a liquid exists. Like now there is no film in between, so force cannot be balanced. Earlier when the film was there inside also, the force on the two sides were balanced and the loop were in arbitrary shape. Now due to this prick, the inner film will burst and only outer film exists, and we can see due to the forces automatically it is pulled in outward direction and finally the loop will take a shape of a circle. Because we can see here if outward forces are acting on the loop, it will have a tendency to acquire a shape in which all the forces will balance, and that's why it will take the shape of a circle. This experiment you can also perform at your home and understand, and there's a very good experiment to understand how the force of surface tension act on a line or a segment on which only one side the film or liquid surface exists.